Well, well, well. The Moose finally decided to show up. Avs win 6-3 over the Winnipeg Jets in Game 5 to win the series 4-1. Look, don't get me wrong. This was a pretty darn good series. These are definitely two good hockey teams, and the Avs was clearly the better team, and they deserved to win the series as they did. Nonetheless, hockey is really stupid. This was a clinching game for the Avs, which means they're a top 8 team in the league this year. And this was an elimination game for Winnipeg, meaning their backs were against the wall. Both teams scored an own goal in this game. Sometimes I question basing my livelihood off of a children's game where teams score on themselves when they're some of the best teams in the league. I think that's fair. The Avs at least get it over with quickly, scoring on themselves a minute and 15 seconds into the game. The Jets are going to create a quality chance on the near side here, but it ultimately ends up underneath Georgiev. It is loose behind him, and the Avs recognize that. So everyone crashes the net, and it's ultimately Josh Manson to pull it out from this pile. And in hindsight, he probably could have stuffed this under Georgiev and gotten a whistle here, but Manson is just trying to get this out of danger and clear it down the ice. Unfortunately, Arturi Lehkonen is stepping right into his path as he goes to clear this, and he rips it off of Lehkonen and into his own net. Yep, that happened. It's crazy to me. These are the best players in the world, and just happens semi-regularly in this sport that you just score on yourself. Like I said, hockey's dumb. Thankfully, that does not shake the Avs mentally at all. They go to work, they dominate the next portion of this game, and they get that goal back pretty quickly. A clean breakout by Makar and MacKinnon for the Avs here gets the Avs up the ice and ultimately into the zone where MacKinnon drops a puck for Mikko, and you pretty consistently see the Avs star players do this. They get two players to latch onto the puck carrier, be it MacKinnon or in this case Mikko. They wait for one of their defensemen to jump into the play and they give them a ton of room to work with. In this case, it's a very nice read from Toews to, instead of pull the trigger, find a Nichushkin on the backside wide open in the circle, and Nichushkin makes a nice finish out of it. There's your first Moose sighting, but far more interestingly, goal number 7 for Val Nichushkin. He now leads the entire NHL in playoff goals this season. 7 goals in a 5-game series is crazy. That would be it for the scoring in the first. I do think the Avs were the better team in the first period. Certainly the first portion of it, they were dominating possession of the puck. Winnipeg did have some pushback. You would expect that, a team going up against elimination, but no other goals were scored. The second period sees the Avs' depth continue to be effective in this series. This is just good old-fashioned hard work from your fourth line. They get it out high. Manson takes a low percentage shot to get it in deep, and Trenin just finds the rebound and goes to work with the puck. His initial shot, super low danger, but creates a rebound, and then he's the man who recognizes where the puck is and just outworks everybody, gets a stick lift in, finds the puck, is able to drag it to the front of the net, and you see the forwards on the Jets side all just sleeping, not helping their D out at all. Not saying the Jets D played it well, because they didn't, but a little support back here and this doesn't happen. Trenin's able to step out into the slot and finish. I love seeing Trenin get rewarded there, just outworking Jets, and finally gets to put one in the back of the net. He's been a horse all of this series, doing a lot of that dirty work, even if he hasn't gotten rewarded for it too much. Great to see him get one into the net there. Unfortunately, the Avs do take a few penalties in this second period, and one of them does end up costing them their lead. We've seen this play to a T before in this series. Jets working up high, down low, around the perimeter. It's ultimately a Josh Morrissey shot with bodies in front that finds the net. Just this play that has worked against the Avs, particularly on their penalty kill in this series. There's been one too many goals against the Avs in this series that have gone in from that point area, particularly on the penalty kill. The Avs need to figure out a way to prevent this from continuing to happen, whether that's moving the man in front and giving Georgiev a clean look at the puck, or challenging that guy out high a little bit harder. The fact of the matter is, you cannot continue to give up that goal in these playoffs if you want to go do the thing. Thankfully, the hockey gods decided to right the puck luck in this second period for Colorado. There's a lot of solid play here in this breakout. Lehkonen getting it up into the neutral zone. It's eventually kicked through, and Mittelstadt is able to find it and create this possession for Colorado. Gains the blue line. A great job by Mikko. Caught out there with a weird shift change where he's out there with the second line. Doesn't complicate things, just drives the net, helps create space, which allows Mittelstadt to get it over to Lehkonen coming in late. Lehkonen doesn't shoot this. He's looking for Mittelstadt on the backside, I'm pretty sure. He passes it right to Neil Pionk. It's what he does. And Neil Pionk puts it directly into his own net. Okay, I guess that's a thing that just happens still. The second period on the whole, the Jets really did push. They outshot the Avs 18-11. It felt like they were really trying to survive at that point. Georgiev played great, made multiple huge saves for the Avs to allow them to get this lead back. Unfortunately, the new guy makes a big mistake early in the third. This should be a pretty routine nothing breakout for the Jets. The Avs have a 3-on-3. It is a little awkward on this backside with Ross Colton coming in late, but Kovalenko doesn't recognize where his teammates are on the ice and who's covering what. As the puck carrier and Ehlers cuts across Kovalenko, Kovalenko is going to stick with the puck carrier here, despite having a defenseman to cover the back guy and then Ross Colton coming up that side of the ice to help with the puck carrier. The expectation here is that Colton switches onto the puck carrier and Kovalenko takes the fourth man in here, covering all of your bases. Your defensemen have the two deep players. It's not all that complicated, but Kovalenko just isn't prepared for this. He just gets a little bit lost and sticks with the puck carrier, which leaves not only an open man, but Kovalenko and Colton even collide on this play, and all of a sudden Tyler Toffoli is going to beat you. It's clear Kovalenko has not had enough time to pick up the Avs' defensive systems fully at this point, and the Avs do run a particularly complicated defensive system, so this isn't a huge surprise to see a mistake like this, but still a big moment where it's a tough one to swallow. That puts the game back to 3-3, and you're in a dogfight at this point. You know Winnipeg isn't going to go down easy. Except, the Avs brought a moose to a dogfight, and a dog ain't winning that fight. It's a dumped-in puck. The Avs have found a lot of success on dump-ins against Winnipeg. The Jets just weren't able to keep up with the Avs' aggressive pressure there. An initial chance that could have gone to Mikko doesn't quite work out, but Val continues to battle in the corner and is able to win that puck to MacKinnon. It's good hard work from your best players. MacKinnon, after dancing a bit, just gets it back out high. Taves throwing this one in, and Mikko Rantanen is about to get a tip on a puck. He hasn't scored a goal all series. Why keep doing all the fancy shit? Go to Pizza Hut, get a puck, get a stick, score a goal, win the series. A beautiful tip by Mikko, his first goal of the series. He really haven't had enough out of him for most of this series. I know he's racked up points, but clearly through the first four games hadn't played his best. He shows up when the Avs need him most. That ends up being the series-winning goal. And then, just in case, he makes sure to add another one. All right, he got a greasy one. That means the moose is activated. The Avs are going to get out of their own zone here as some nice work up the boards, and MacKinnon just lights a man on fire, creates a 2-on-1 with the two guys. You don't want that to happen to you. A great job by MacKinnon to get this pass through, and Mikko puts the dagger home. That goal is Makar to MacKinnon to Rantanen. By the way, you wonder why we call them superstars. They show up when they are needed most, in the biggest moments, when you're trying to close out a series. It's those guys that you rely on, and more often than not, they get the job done. The reality is the Avs' depth and second line scoring has been unbelievably good in this series, and that's great to have, but to expect it to continue at that level, going deeper, playing against other really good teams, is unrealistic. So you need those superstars to get that confidence, get going a little bit, and be those producers for the Avs. It's a great way to finish this series for Colorado. And I'll be honest here, Winnipeg kind of went away after this game was 5-3. Looked like they were ready for some golf. Eventually, Josh Manson throws one into the empty netter, and that is the series over. Really a darn near perfect series for the Avs. I know game one was horrible in many ways, but they built themselves into the series. I think they played better and better as the series went on, and they ultimately dominated the Jets in four of the five games, and really on the underlings, even in the 7-6 game one, just struggled to get a save in that one. And maybe most importantly out of all of this, we watched Georgiev's play get better and better through the series, and he now has backstopped them through the first round. That's the first time Georgiev has done that for the Avs. If he can continue to play confident, sky's the limit for this team. That is the end of this game and series video review. Thank you for watching. Head on over to thednvr.com for all of our coverage. I am Rudo, and bring on round two.